It's safe to say that Marjorie Greene has not taken the recent raid on Donald Trump well. Her meltdown evolved over time on social media. Even though she is technically banned from social media, she gets to use her official congressional account the same exact way she would be using her personal one. And so we first got this, the upside down flag, which has a meaning. It has to do with grave harm to the Republic, those sorts of things. So a little bit of an exaggeration, but she immediately posts that. And then jumps to, this is the rogue behavior of communist countries, not the United States of America. These are the types of things that happen in countries during civil war. The political persecution must stop. I don't know what communism has to do with literally any of this. I think there are plenty of corrupt countries that operate under unfettered capitalism that lock up political opponents. So that's a weird flex there. But she is also, of all of the people who love chanting lock up Hillary Clinton, lock up who, lock up Biden, lock up Hunter Biden, she is perhaps the most enthusiastic. So for her to talk about the political persecution must stop is a bit fresh. But she also agrees with something that we've seen quite a bit of since the raid, and that is that the FBI needs to go, tweeting in all caps, defund the FBI. Remember how that was a bad framing for defund the police? Well, it's good now when it comes to the FBI. See, the police, they are brutal to regular people. The FBI investigates the wealthy and well-connected. So it makes sense that you gotta keep the one with the boot on the neck of the regular people and get rid of the one that could potentially investigate her. That makes sense to me. If that's not on the nose enough, the defund co-optation, Liz Wheeler just tweets, abolish the FBI. One of these right-wing media people. Well, but you stole that too. You said we couldn't do that with ICE, despite the murders and rapes and abuse and all of that. Anyway, she goes. She apparently is informed of the fact that that's hypocritical, and then responds: the people claiming abolish the FBI is the same as defund the police are the same people who say men can be women. Reality isn't your strength. Good to know you're cool with a communist FBI, though. If you're waiting to find out if she's gonna define what is communist about investigating President Trump, she is not going to. We don't know. And she also, by the way, like all of them, continues to insist that Donald Trump won the election. So the whole reality thing loses a bit of its sting there. But anyway, there's more to it. Threats of what is happening will not be tolerated. We are coming. I don't know what that means. Does that mean another insurrection? That's probably what it means. They love throwing out these empty threats. Scott Adams tweeted, I will allow my government 48 hours to explain itself. And then what exactly happens after the 48 hours, what exactly the guy who did Dilbert will do is not made clear. It's kind of a vague threat, David.
Maybe he's threatening to leave the country, and maybe Marjorie Taylor Greene can leave as well. That if we don't defund the FBI and federal law enforcement, then Marjorie Taylor Greene decides, no, this is, oh, wait a second. I think those Republicans who were telling Democrats a few years ago, worrying about George Floyd to, well, in any case, I love this, that Marjorie Taylor Greene wants to defund the FBI and others want to abolish the FBI, because this is a starting point. Let's go ahead and have this conversation about, okay, well, what would you replace the FBI with? What would you replace federal law enforcement? How would they be different? Because I think we do need to take a very strong look at law enforcement at every level, the local level, the state, the federal level, and look at this culture that is causing too many innocent black people to be, have the hell beat out of them by rogue cops. And that also extends to a certain extent to certain federal agents. So yeah, let's have this conversation. Let's tear it all down and see what's the best way we could build it back up. And if you want a serious conversation, Marjorie Taylor Greene, what would you propose in lieu of the FBI? How would you do it? And let's have this discussion. But I don't think she's capable of discussion, so this is probably a meaningless point on my part.
Sorry. Exactly. Yeah, I don't think she's gonna take you up on that. super fast, I just wanna respond to a couple of her points. Elections are how Americans solve political differences, not by radicalizing our federal law enforcement to take political enemies out. But okay, so, but on both sides of that, you are the worst possible person to deliver that message. You don't accept the results of any elections. Years later, you don't accept them. So how exactly would that be the means to solve our political differences? You don't accept them. Also, not by radicalizing our federal law. You want to lock up your political opponents. It makes, save America, stop communism. What does this have to do with communism? It's Joe Biden. He's basically a Republican of the 1980s. He's not a communist. This has nothing to do with collectivizing the workforce or anything. I don't even know how that would work. But if you think that she's coming for the FBI and for Joe Biden, all that, that's true. But not just that. She ends part of her screed with, "In January, we take on the enemy within," which I take as a threat to Republicans who aren't sufficiently combative. I think that that's talking about continuing to make the Republican Party worse. I could be wrong. She's got a lot of enemies. It's hard to tell at this point.
Or maybe she wants another. Maybe she wants another January 6th. I mean, can you imagine how crazy the vitriol would be if Christopher Wray, the FBI director, had not been named FBI director by Donald Trump, and God forbid it had been some other, you know, Democrat or somebody who was a leftover. Can you imagine how crazy people would, but then when you tell people, well, wait a second, but Christopher Wray, by most accounts, is a Republican who was named by Donald Trump. Well, and, you know, suddenly the argument goes askew. Well, what is it? Is this communism with a, I mean, it doesn't make any sense, but that's part of the shtick on the right, is this isn't about making sense and about having logic. This is about touching emotional feelings that a lot of Republicans and right-wing lunatics have right now, never mind whether there's any logic behind it.
Yeah, someone, Ducey, actually brought up that point this morning on Fox and Friends. And the dude that they were talking to, like, scrambled to be like, well, you know, Trump had to get rid of the previous leader of the FBI. Let's not go into exactly why he wanted to do that. And so he had to choose someone. So he chose Chris Wray, but he didn't like him. He didn't like him when he was in office. He still chose him. He's a Republican. He's the head of the FBI. Of course he's a Republican. They've all been Republicans. Anyway.
I mean, so we'll come to find out. I guarantee we're going to come to find out that the federal judge who signed off on this raid, I'm willing to bet that it's going to be a Trump appointed judge. And that'll just cause, you know, the MAGA crowd to go nuts, and Marjorie Taylor Greene, then I don't know what she's going to do with her communism, but look for a lot of self implosions on the right.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.